Tafa yatufu. Tuf. Tufa. I'm just giving you hints, brother. You know, vav has to come after the first form. Taudu ud. Return. Uda, udu, fine. Tatubu. Tub. Tub. And then huma. Tuba. And then tubu. With vav. Anti. Tubi. With vav. Tuba and tupna. This is a very nice one, but zaka yazuku. Taste. How do you say taste it? Zuk. Zukhu or zukha. Zuk. And then zuka with vav. And then antum zuku. And then zuki. Zuka and zukana. Fine, brothers and sisters? Brother, ba'a, what will be the amar? Yabi'u, tabi'u, bih. The ayin kalima got completely dropped. Okay, nama yanamu. Ya nam. See? It's very easy for us to say nim. No, it is nam. Why nam? Because it is tanamu. Are you with me? If I write down tanamu, I'm going a little fast, you know why? Because you are now very strong. We have been working on the verbs for a long time. Tanamu. How do I make amar? I give a sukun here. I chop this off. No, there's a sukun here also. So it goes out. What happens now? Nam. What will be for dual? Nama. Remember? Nama. Okay? The alif will remain. And will be for antum, namu. Are you with me? I'll write down quickly. Tana, ma, ni. Make amar, brother. Noon will be dropped. This will be dropped. I don't have to drop anything more. So what is now? Nama. And if I say, Tanamuna. Are you with me? Tanamuna. How do I make amar? Namu. Got the idea? Same will be if I say bia. This is your amar. And what will be for huma? Bia. What it will be? Bia. What will be for antum? Bi'u. Anti, bi'i. You have to keep that in mind. But you got to practice this. As I said, at least, minimum 5 conjugations from Bab Nasara, 5 conjugations from Bab Daraba, and two, you can do 2. Please try to do it. As if you can't do too many, at least do by tomorrow at 2:00. 2:00, inshallah. Okay, brothers and sisters. Now we are ready to go over to our main lesson now, inshallah. So far, interesting, brothers and sisters. And you see, you can understand, you know, why are you understanding? Because alhamdulillah, you worked very hard. And this mutaharik pronoun does not gabrify us. We are not gabrified by mutaharik pronouns. We know it, inshallah. Now, brother, again the spelling rules for ja'a yaji'u. You know, Hamza has a spelling rule. So if I say ja'a, brothers and sisters, ya-ji. Remember, it is ja'a, ya-ji, ya-ji, then U will be written outside the ya. Because you are pronouncing everything in the verb. Ya, ji, u. So everything is pronounced, so you will write down ha. But make it majzum. How will you write down? No, ya, ji. Ya, ji. So you will write down ya. Now this is, ya has been dropped. Now, what is this now? Kursi. For Hamza. So you will now put it right inside it or at the corner of it. Okay? See here, it is outside. Because you are pronouncing, yeah, here your ya has been dropped. So you have to write it on top of it or little inside. Because that is now kursi. Are you with me, Sister Fatima? If I say to you, lam here, what will happen, Sister Fatima, here? I'll give a sukoon. Sahi? Now there are two sukoons, so this gets dropped. Now there is a kasra before Hamza, G. So Hamza gets a kursi of ya. So this is the kursi. Abagan sisters? It is the kursi with Hamza sitting on it. But inside. Here the Hamza is outside. Keep that in mind. This is also explained in the lesson. Okay, brothers and sisters. Al-Mudarris. What is the meaning of Ja'a? To come. Very important verb. Mata jiyata min juddata ya Khalid. Translation, brother? When did you come from Jeddah, O Khalid? Jietu amsi. Jietu amsi. Where is the verb, Sister Hamza? Jie. Where is the verb? Jie. How will I describe it? Fi'lun madin mabni wala sukun. When it is mutaharik pronoun, then the fi'l madi will become mabni ala sukun. When it is sakin pronouns, then it will always be mabni ala fata, or in this case, dhamma. Dhamma. Okay, inshallah. Okay. So, jiyatu amsi. What is jiyatu? Fi'l and fa'il. Tu is the fa'il. And what is amsi? Zarfu? Zaman. Masha'Allah. Aja'a Ibrahimu ma'aka. Ja'a Ibrahimu ma'aka. Here is the verb, ja'a. Fi'lu madin mabniun ala fata. Ja'a fata mabniun ala fata. Okay, where is the file? Ibrahim. Brothers, we cannot make mistakes. We have made lots of mistakes before. But not now. Now, alhamdulillah, we are alert. We are very careful. Okay, brother, look at it. Lam yaji baud. What is the meaning of it? Lam yaji. He did not come. Make into ma. What will you say? Ma ja'a, mashallah. Excellent, Sister Hafsa. Zadikillahu ilman, may Allah bless you in knowledge and all of us, inshallah. Ma ja'a. Are you with me? Or lam yaji. Both has same meaning. Ma ja'a or lam yaji. I am just trying to tell you, do not forget that we have the meaning is same, but we can change the format of the verb. Ma ja'a or lam yaji. What is the meaning of ba'du? Yet. Ba'du means yet. Lam yaji ba'du. He has not returned yet. Okay. Sa yaji'u. Now look at it. If you have highlighter, please highlight yaji. So you know how the hamza is written. And then you see sa yaji'u, highlight that. And if you have different highlighter, use different highlighters. Are you with me, brother? And see how yaji sa yaji'u is written. Al yawm aw gadan, inshallah. Azurta safira. Azurta safira. Where is the verb? Zor. What is the Fine. And what is a Safira? Mafulun bi. Did you visit the ambassador? Zahabtu ila maktabihi walam ajidhu. Lam ajidhu. Wajada yajidu. Yajidu, tajidu, tajidu, ajidu, najidu, lam ajid. Inshallah. Samiatu. I heard annahu that he is lam yakun. Fi Jeddah. I heard that he was not in Jeddah. Zakal Yawma. Okay, brother. Here is our nice treat. Zakal Yawma. Brother Abdul Samad, what is Zaka, brother? Zaka is Susamsa? Zarf, Zarf. Susamsa? Say loudly. It is Zarf, brother. Why it is Zarf? Yauma has come. So if Zaka, what is Yauma? Badal. See, our mind should think. It's very interesting, brother. This is the way we will study Quran also. Inshallah. So Zaka here means Zalika. Now this is, we will study this in book 3, brothers and sisters. Everything that we have studied, all the lessons will be repeated, but in much more detail. So Zarf lesson consists of 10 to 12 pages. It is very interesting. In every way we will, Dr. Abdurrahim will teach us how the Zarf works, you know. There is another name for Zarf, and that is Maf'ulun Fihi. That comes Maf'ulun Fihi. Maf'ulun Fihi. Okay? And that we will study in book 3. But you can say Maf'ulun Fihi Zarf or Zarf Maf'ulun Fihi. For our, you know, simple way of understanding, it's good enough, inshallah. Once we learn, then we can go in detail. Okay, brothers and sisters. Al-Mudarris. Ya Adnanu innaka gibta. Okay, brother. What is gibta? What ghee tells you? No, it is ghaba. Ghaba. And what will be the mudariya? Yaghibu. Ghaba, yaghibu. Yaghibu. And then ghaba, ghaba, ghabu, ghabat, ghabata, gibna, gibta, gibtuma. Okay. Innaka gibta isbu'aini. You remain absent 2 weeks. What is isbu'aini, brother? Zarf, mashallah. See, isbu'ani, isbu'aini. It's mansub. It is zarf, okay. Fa'ayna kunta. What is, how you translate? Aina kunta? Where? Were you? Where were you? Where were you? Aina kunta? Where were you? Okay. Kuntu fil mustashfa. Okay, brother. Kana yakunu. Kuntu. What is tu, brother? Is it a file? No. Ismu kana, brother. Kana. So many things to remember. Brothers and sisters, if we keep on learning Arabic, we will never get sick with Alzheimer's disease. Because our mind is always, always active. You are thinking all the time. Arabic makes you think. Arabic makes you think all the time. Brothers and sisters? Okay, brother and sister, where is the verb? Kun. How will I describe? Kun. Felu madin nakisun. Mabniun ala sukun. What will be the two? Ismu kana. Ismu kana. Fine, brother, sister. Where is our khabar kana? If there is a ism, there has to be khabar. Fil mustashfa. Jar majrur. Shibu jumla. Khabar. But then when we go in book 3, we will go in further detail. Remember, there is still more details coming. But, brother Hassan, when I say details, They are all interesting things coming. You will love it, inshallah. Fine, brothers and sisters. Kuntu maridan. Now, this is very simple. Kuntu maridan. What is maridan? Why it is mansub? Khabar khana is always mansub. Mashallah. Oh, jiddan. Mafulun mutlak. There is a little explanation for mafulun mutlak coming in a sentence, but I don't want to go in detail. Inshallah, mafulun mutlak will do in book 3. Inshallah. Wallahi. Wallahi. What is wallahi? Qasam. What is wa? Wawul qasam. What is it, brother? And what is wawul qasam? Wawul qasam is a preposition. Harf jar is a majrur. So, Allahi will become majrur. Brother, I tell you, honestly, when I learned all these things and when I was trying to read slowly Quran and try to understand, I was so much surprised, but pleasant, beautiful surprises with the things that person reads the Quran doesn't understand. What is after wallahi? Lakad. What is this lakad, brother? What is this lakad? The qad is for tahqiq. Tahqiq. And what is the la then? La will come for a jawabu qasam. Ji? No. I said jawabu qasam. Are you with me? Jawabu qasam. Whenever there is a qasam, the jawab will start with la, provided there is no nafi in the verb. There is no nafi in the verb. Brother, look at this, brother. Watini. What is watini? Qasam. Allah is swearing. I swear by the fig. There is such deep meaning into all these things. Watini. Why it is majroor? Because wawul qasam is harf jar. Watini. Wazaituni. Waturi sinina. Wahadal bala. Dil. Amini. Kasra. Why? Wow. Because everything is now matufun ala tini. Okay, what is after that? Why lakad? Jawabu kasam. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Jawabu kasam. La. There are two things in lakad. Kad comes for madi. Kad comes for madi. Kad comes for madi. To emphasize. Okay? If there is a negation, then you don't use. Okay? But otherwise, you will use kad for madi. Okay, brothers and sisters, if I say, Aina Hamidun, you can say, Zahaba, he went. But you, when you say kad Zahaba, means he has gone. Okay? Now, what happens, brothers and sisters, when you read in the Quran, lakad? Lakad kana lakum fi rasulillahi uswatun hasanatun. Okay, brother, what is lakad here? What is la? What is la? Jawab, where is the qasam? Mahzuf. Can you imagine? Allah is swearing. When you see lakad, lam is for the qasam. As a jawab. Oh, where is the qasam? Mahzuf. Then when you read it, you have to understand it. Brothers and sisters, you have to understand it. So here is the ayah, brother. Lakad kana lakum fi rasulillahi uswatun hasanatun. Uswatun is your ismu kana. Are you with me? Ismu kana. Marfu. Okay, brothers and sisters. So you remember lakad now. This comes for a jawabu qasam. Lam is for jawabu qasam and kad for tahqiq. Wallahi. He's swearing, Wallahi lakad kidtu amutu. How will you translate this, brother? I almost died. I almost died. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? So what is kada? It is madi. Kada yakadu. So kada, kada, kadu, kadat, kadata, kidna, kidta, lakad, kidtu, amutu. Mata yamutu. Now remember, kada, yakadu, kada is also a weak verb. So it will have ism. So where is the ism of kidtu? Tu. Where is the ism? In kidtu, where is the ism? Tu. Where is the khabar? What is amutu? Fail, mudharia, mafun bi dhamma. Where is the file? Where is the file? Mustatir, takdiruhu, ana. Are you with me? Takdiruhu, ana. So what will you say? Jumla failure, coming as a khabar for kaada. Wallahi, lam arif zalika. Wallahi, but the lakad did not come. Because it is lam, negation.